Mihama Saru. So firstly, who is here from representing the indigenous communities?
首先我想问一下在座有哪些是部落的代表，代表部落来的，可以举个手吗？
部落来的，
部落来的，部落来的，不要说代表了，是部落来的，是不是？
好好 ，I am here representing my tribe.
那我在这里呢，也是代表我的部落过来的。
Firstly, I need to introduce myself to you.
就首先呢，先向我向各位自我介绍。
Hihi ana to kurere wai kuta tangi wai a papue nuku. Wai hihi wai ha ha wai pu hake hake mai aku kamo. Nā mahara nui, nā mahara loa, nā mahara mauro e. Hākui mā hākuro mā, e matakuna kiri pārama, kia tū, kia aho, kia matāra.Mai te tārei o te ihua tamata kapua, ki te uru mo te hoi o Ngātaro i rangi. Ma make tū ki tongari, ko tongari ro te maunga, ko taupo nui a te te moana, ko Ngāti tū whare tō te iwi. My mountain is Tongariro.
我的山是 Tongariro.
My ocean is Taupo Moana.
我的海是 Taupo Moana.
My tribe is Ngāti Tūwharetoa.
我的部落是 Ngāti
Tūwharetoa.
Tūwharetoa.
Okay. When we talk about volcanoes and geothermal, we first must address our ancestor Luaumoko.
那我们讲到是火山，讲到地热的话，我们首先就一定要提到是我们的祖先 Luaumoko.
Luaumoko was left with our earth mother, Papa Tuanuku.
那Luaumoko 呢，他是就是在地留在地上，然后一开始呢是天上天跟地的之间留下来的小孩子。
And he reminds us he's still there with geothermal activity, volcanoes, and earthquakes.
那他透过火山，透过这些地热的活动，还有透过地震，提醒了我们他的存在。
So we pay respects to our ancestor before we talk geothermal.
所以我们讲到地热之前，先尊重我们的祖先。
5,000 or 6,000 years ago, we left Taiwan.
5,000-6,000年左右的时候呢，我们离开台湾。
Sorry for leaving you behind. We left you to look after our island. And our geothermal. Our ancestors discovered every island in the Pacific. Before arriving in Aotearoa, New Zealand.
最后终于抵达了 Aotearoa, 纽西兰。
This is what they call the Ring of Fire.
那这个呢是他们所谓的火之链。
The Pacific Plate.
基本上就是太平洋板块。
We already knew that islands were developed from volcanic activity.
我们其实都已经知道说，岛屿之所以出现涌起呢，就是因为火山的行动活动。
So there's a well-known theory that in discovering all those islands, not only were we navigating by the stars.
那所以呢，这其实都是大家已知的理论，就是我们之所以呢去发现这些岛屿。
Following the ocean currents.
不只是因为我们跟着星星走，跟着海流走。
Following the whales, the birds, and the other marine life.
跟着鸟，跟着鲸鱼，跟着所有的海洋生物走。
We also knew the geothermal plate. flight connections.
我们也知道这整个地热板块的这些连接。
This is Hawaii.
这边是夏威夷。
There is Tahiti.
上面是大，这边是大溪地。
There's Tonga up there.
这边是东加。
You change two letters, and the Hawaiian language and our Māori language is the same.
你只要改两个字，我夏威夷的语言跟我的语言就是一模一样。
The Cook Island language is exactly the same as our Māori language.
这边Cook Island 这一块的这个岛屿的语言呢，跟我的语言就是完全一模一样。
These two volcanoes here.
这一块这两个火山。
Ngāruahoe, Ruapehu, they are in my tribal area.
这两个火山呢，我可能翻译不太好，但总之它在我的部落地区。
That is them there.
就是这两块。
That's Ruapehu, Ngāruahoe, Tongariro.
一二三。
That is our lake.
然后那边是我们的湖，这是我部落的湖。
We got the lake back in 1992.
我们一九九二年的时候夺回我们的湖。
The lake bed, we've got the lake bed back.
我们把，原本是
the land.
哦，所以原本的土地呢是在就是水呢是在土地在水之下。
It was stolen from us.
原本呢是他们别人把我们偷走，所以我们又再要回来。
Most of the land you can see.Is in our tribal ownership.
那这边你可以看到，大多数的土地呢，都是由我们族人所持有、所拥有。
This photo is taken from the top of this Mauna, this mountain, which is Tauhara.
那这个照片呢，是在这座山上，通塔这座山上拍下来的。
I live by that mountain.
我就是住在这座山上。
That is looking at these mountains were taken from us, or we gifted them. We gifted them to the government because if we didn't gift them, the government would have taken them.
那这些山呢，是我们最后赠予给政府的。因为我们之所以赠予给政府，是因为我们不赠予的话，政府也会拿走。
So our chief gifted the mountains, but we kept the peaks.
所以呢，我们的酋长呢就把这个山呢赠予给了政府，但是我们把山顶这边呢我们留下来。
Because the peaks are sacred to us.
因为这个山顶对我们来说是圣地。
This is my ancestor Ngātoroirangi.
这是我的祖先 Ngātoroirangi.
A relative of mine carved his face into the rocks beside our lake.It's a depiction of our ancestor.
那可以看到，是我其中一个亲戚就把他的这个脸，他去描述我这个祖先的这个脸呢，把它放在了是刻在了是在湖边的这个山上面山壁上。
He arrived in Aotearoa on the Te Arawa canoe, and then traversed inland to discover our tribal area, and named it for our tribe.
他呢，在他也是呢，从搭着独木舟来到了这个纽西兰，一路呢往内陆走，最后呢找到了，发现了我们的部落，成立了我们的部落。
One thing we had to do to prove our connection to geothermal was to explain our relationship, our stories, our songs, and our history with geothermal.So this was the process we had to go through to prove to the government that we had historical connection.
那一开始的时候呢，我们要去跟政府证明说我们跟地热就是有这样一个历史的渊源跟联系的时候呢，我们要去解释说在我们的故事里面就有这样子的东西，在我们的歌曲里面、我们的连接里面、所有东西里面本身就已经有地热这样的一个连接了。
Yet we were there before then.
所以我们早就在那之前就已经先拥有这个地热的资源。
This place is called Ketetahi.
这个地方叫做 Ketetahi.
It is on the side of our mountain Tongariro.
在这个 Tongariro 山的旁边。
Ngā Toroirangi went to climb Tongariro.
那我们的祖先呢？那陀罗伊那里去爬了这个山。
The mountain. Went to climb the mountain.
好，他去爬山，他去爬那座山。
The weather changed, and he got he was facing death from the cold winds from the south.
那因为天气突然骤变，所以因为那个冷风，他差点死掉。
So this is the myth. Sorry, this is the myth.
哦，对，这个是我们的神话，所以先跟大家讲，这是我们证明年景的一个神话故事。
He called out to his sisters Kuiwai and Hongaro.
所以呢，他就
his sisters, he called out to his sisters.
他去呼唤他的姐妹。
Still in Hawaiki, so they're in Hawaiki.
他们那时候呢是在 Hawaiki 这个地方。
He called out to his sisters to send him fire and warmth so that he may survive.
所以他就去叫呼唤他的姐妹，叫他姐妹从那边呢送火跟温暖过来，这样的话他才能活下去。
His sisters sent baskets of heat and fire for his warmth.
所以呢，他的姐妹呢就送来了一篮的温暖跟火，然后让他保持温暖。
Only one got to Tongariro, the others got lost on the way.
但是呢，这全部好几篮里面呢，只有一篮最后呢达到了他的祖先的身上，其他的都在沿路上的时候都遗落遗失了。
Once he recovered and was warmed up, he then threw that kit into the side of the mountain, and that spring is now called Kikitahi.
那他一旦复原了以后，又才重新暖起来以后呢，他就把那个火呢，跟他的这个温暖的东西呢，就丢到了旁边，丢到了旁边，串出来的就是这个温泉。现在这个温泉就叫做 Kikitahi.
So that's a myth.
所以这个是他们一直以来就有的神话。
The traditional knowledge within that myth maps the connection through the Pacific, through the White Island, across the North Island to our mountains down here.
所以呢，这个神话里面内含的一个传统知识呢，其实就连接到了从太平洋地区连到了怀特岛，再到了北岛，最后呢，经过了他们的山里面，连到他们这边内陆的地方。
So our ancestors had the knowledge of the geothermal underground connection all the way out in the Pacific, right through the Pacific plate, all the way to our mountains in the central North Island.
所以你可以看到是这个知识的是知道说从他们老祖先就已经知道是这整个地下这个连接从一路从太平洋一路到他们内陆这个山脊下。
That island there is called Whakaari or White Island.
这个岛屿呢叫做 Whakaari 或者是怀特岛。
And that island, that's here.
就这一块，那个岛就是左边那个三角形。
Off the coast.
就在海岸边。
So we also had to prove our traditional use with the geothermal.
那当时呢，他们也必须要证明说他们传统上怎么去使用地热资源。
This village, it's a traditional village, still here today, called Whakarewarewa.
那这个村落呢是一个传统的村落，现在还是在持续矗立在那里呢。
It is on. It's on top. It's on top of a geothermal field.
其实它就在地热的资源地之上，各位可以看到。
In Rotorua, some of you may have been to Rotorua.
那 Rotorua 我不知道大家有没有去过这个地方，它就在那边。
I also descend from that tribe.
他自己呢也是来自于那一个部落。
But I wasn't born there.
但不是生于那边，他是其中一个支部。
That traditional cooking, they used to just put the baskets of food in the hot water or in the mud and would cook.
所以这是他们传统烹饪的方式，你可以看到篮子就直接放在水底下，或者是泥土上面，或者是泥浆上面，然后接着就可以煮。
This is more modern, where they built steam pits. You put your food in, put the lid on, come back in a couple of hours, and your food is cooked.
那这个是比较现右边的是比较现代的这种烹饪的方式，一样把它这个盖起来，变成有点像是蒸汽的一个设备。那这样的话，你就把食物放到里面盖起来，几个小时之后，食物就煮好了。
Like you, geothermal was used for healing, medicinal, and well-being.
那就像各位，其实地热的资源呢，也用来去有疗效，有这种药性，然后同时也让各位的是感觉就是有福祉的感觉，变比较好的。
Those geothermal pools are owned by one of my relatives.
那这个温泉呢，是他其中一个亲戚的资产。
The geothermal terraces are used to cool the water off before they run into the pool.
那可以看到右下角那边呢是这个温泉的梯田，就是这样的话呢，一阶一阶温度就会降低，然后接着最后呢流入到是可以泡的温泉里面。
And this is up behind it. This is a place we call the English name is Craters of the Moon. It's just a geothermal wonderland.
那右边那在右边这两张图里面，可以看到后面很多蒸汽，很多蒸汽的这一块呢，其实就很像是月之岛这一块，就是基本上就是地热的这种岛屿呈现出来的这个情况。
So, two of the big enablers for us to get involved in geothermal development was the Treaty of Waitangi. So that's our New Zealand foundation document between Māori and the English.In 1840.
那让我们能够参与地热开发有主要两大因素。第一个呢是 Waitangi 的这个协约，它基本上呢是1840年的时候毛利人跟英国人之间签的一个协定。
The Resource Management Act 1991.
再来呢是1991年的这个资源管理法。
Gives us rights as caretakers and stewards, and it means that anyone who wants to do geothermal development has to get a consent, and they have to consult with us, and we effectively have to approve that consent.
那1991年的这个资源管理法呢，让他们能够成为地热资源的这个照顾者跟管理者，代表是说，如果任何人想要开发这个资源的话，他们必须要获得他们的諮商跟同意，让他们必须要批准以后才能进行开发。
It protects our traditional uses and rights.
那保护了他们传统的使用资源的方式以及他们的权利。
This is nearby where I live. This is in my tribal area.
那这个呢是其实靠我住的地方非常的近，基本上就在我部落那边。
That one and that photo up there is Wairākei Geothermal Field.
那这两个呢就是 Wairākei 的这个地热田地热区。
This was built before I was born.
这是在我出生之前就已经盖好。
So nearly 75 odd years ago.
所以几乎75年前了。
It's old school. They used to pipe the geothermal from the well to the powerhouse. They don't do it like this anymore.
那这个是非常老式的一种发电的方式，你可以看到是这一个这边是用井，然后连接的这个管线，然后到的是发电厂，现在不再用这种方式了。
This is a more modern field.
右下角这边你可以看到是一个比较现代的一个就是地热区。
That is our mountain.
后面是我们的山。
And so this one you can see they put the geothermal turbine pretty much straight on top of the well.
那这边呢，你可以看到是它的这个地热的涡轮呢，基本上就是直接在它的井上面。
Tuarapaki is one of our tribal entities.
Tuarapaki 呢是算作我们其中一个部落的实体。
Tina will talk more to our the type of structures we have, where we own geothermal power stations and subsidiary businesses.
那Tina 等一下呢会比较聚焦在跟大家讲一下说在这些电厂里面他们的整个拥有的架构结构是怎么样，然后以及相关的一些事业的连接是什么。
So.These facilities are owned collectively by a sub-tribe of our tribe.
那这个设施呢，这一整个发电这些设施呢，其实是由我们部落的其中一个子部落呢一起共同持有的，集体拥有的。
That is a 115 megawatt power plant.
那这个电厂呢是115 megawatt。
These are glass houses.
那这个大家应该知道就是温室。
Heated by geothermal.
是由热能加热的温室。
Where they grow food, a lot of different types of foods for local and international markets.
所以里面呢就可以种植食物，供给不管是国内还是国外的需求。
This is a dairy factory.
那这个是乳厂。
Dairy milk factory.
牛乳厂。
The drying plant is heated by geothermal.
所以它基本上呢，整个干燥要变成奶粉的整个过程呢，也是由地热来进行的。
I am chairman of a large farm trust.
我是一个资金信托的一个主席。
We send our milk to that dairy factory.
我们也会把我们的奶就直接送到那边他们的生产公司基地。
They sell the milk to Taiwan.
然后再把牛奶卖给台湾。
So next time you drink milk, it's coming from my cows.
下次喝牛奶的时候就知道是我的牛弄的。
There's a good chance.
有很大的机会是这样。
We've made an investment into this company called Geo40.
那我们也投资了这家公司叫做 Geo40.
When I say we, the tribal entity that I'm on the board of.
那我说的我们的投资呢，基本上就是我是担任其中一个董事的这个部落实体。
It's still research and development.
那现在还在研发阶段。
They are extracting lithium from the geothermal field.
他们呢会从
fluid from the geothermal fluid.
他们会从这个地热的这个液体，这个水里面呢，会萃取出锂。
Someone mentioned the prawn farm.
刚刚有人提到的是虾场嘛，养虾池。
We had a board meeting yesterday.
我们昨天才开董事会。
We approved the purchase of this prawn farm.
那我们才批准说要买这个养虾场。
So our tribe is now buying this.
所以我们现在部落的即将要买这个养虾场。
We're going to put in some hot pools.
我们一样会把一些就是温泉这种温池放在里面。
To complement those other the other pools I showed you.
那就跟其他的这一些就是池子给大家看，一起把它放在加在里面变成增建。
But a key component to us buying this is.
我们之所以很大一个关键，之所以买这个养虾场。
Is our rights to the downstream fluid?
是因为我们对它下游的水是有权利的。
So the energy company uses the steam for the power.
所以能源公司呢会拿它用蒸汽来发电。
And we have a 35-year license to the downstream fluid, which we can use for pools, for.The prawn farm, which will convert into other aquaculture type activities, and then the tourism side of the business.
那我们呢有35年的权利呢，能够去使用它的下游使用的水呢，因此我们可以把它发展成不管是温泉啊，或者是我们刚刚讲这个养虾场，或者是可以转做任何水产的养殖，同时也可以发展出观光业。
So that's just a light touch.Of our involvement with geothermal, the key thing for us is we are the caretakers of the resource.
那这个稍微就给大家介绍一下说，说我们呢跟地热的这些关系，最重要的呢是要讲的是我们是这个资源的管理者、照顾者。
And we have to ensure that resource is still there for our grandkids.For our great grandkids and for our great great grandkids. So sustainability and stewardship is our primary responsibility.
所以我们要确保的是这些资源对我们的子子孙孙、下一代、下下一代、下下下一代都永远还在，能够永续下去。所以这对我们来说是净值管理很重要的一块。
谢谢。
Athena, Puerto Catalan, America, Nakia, Kaita, Itinaiwa. Kia ora, ni hao, ne hao, mali mali, masalu. Ko tēnā wehe paihana, Wilson, tōku ingoa. I'm just going to need probably 5 minutes, so I'm going to get you to do some questions to Tim, because I've got to upload my presentation.
好，那 Tina 需要在五分钟的时间，她要把她的简报上传。所以呢，大家这段时间有没有问题要问 Tim 的？
Don't be shy.
大家有点害羞。
我想请教，我很好奇，我刚很专注的一直在看他这样的一个资，这么好的资源的这个部分，就是被政府收化以后，你们是怎么样争把你们这个权益争取回来？你花了多少？应该很艰苦了。你们花了多少时间把它要回来？有碰到什么样的困难，在你们这样把你们的原来的资源争取回来，会遇到什么样最大的这个困扰？这是我脑袋一塞的，真的很漂亮，很丰富的这个天然资源，好不容易被你们收回，就是争取回来，这个我。我很好奇你们是怎么做到的。
So we have been fighting for 160 years.
我们已经奋斗了160年了。
We are still arguing over the ownership of water and geothermal.
但到现在，我们还是在持续奋斗，说到底，水跟地热的拥有权应该是谁
？In the treaty, we got promised undisturbed control and rights over our own assets or taonga. We call them taonga because we didn't have a concept of ownership.
那在协约里面呢，其实他是有肯认说我们有这个我们所有的资产。的这个控制权，的这种权利跟使用的这个权利，其实，在我们的传统里面，我们并没有所谓的持有权、所有权这个概念，我们叫它通用而已。
At the time of the treaty, we owned 100% of Aotearoa. Now we own only 5%.
所以呢，其实，在协约一开始1840讲的那个协约的时候呢，我们100%拥有我们这个土地，但是现在我们只持有5%。
Where we are fortunate with geothermal, most of the geothermal in New Zealand is in our tribal area, in my tribal area.
那我们自己很幸运的是，我们享有的是地热的资源，因为在纽西兰，大多数的地热资源都在我的部落里面。
Because we were inland, we were one of the last tribes to be colonized.
那也因为我们是内陆的部落，所以我们算是最后才被殖民的部落。
The soils in our tribal region are very pumicey and were no good for farming. Hence, we were late in the, you know, we were later to be colonized. We didn't lose as much land.
那因为呢，刚好在我们那一块地方的土地是非常的贫瘠的，不适合种植。这也是为什么他们这么晚才去殖民我们。那也因此，我们反而很幸运的是可以拥有我们的土地。
So by retaining the land.And they have to put the wells on our land that gives us a larger amount of control and involvement in the geothermal projects.
那也因为我们保有这样的土地，然后再加上它是要在我们的地上钻井，所以呢，我们可以有很大一部分的掌控权跟参与的权利。
The government illegally drilled wells on our land.
那政府呢是合法的，在我们的土地上进行钻井。
That took a long time. They eventually sold them back for a dollar.
那他们花了很多时间，结果呢，一直以来他卖回来的价钱是1块钱。
And that was a big enabler for us to then build geothermal power plants But I'm talking a 50-year time frame for that to happen.
那那时候政府是还回购回卖给我们1块钱呢，这也是为什么我们最后是想要自己去拥有这个发电厂。但是这整段时间，我必须要说是我花了50年的时间。
That is the result after 50 years.
所以左边这个这一块呢，其实就是50年的成果。
And just while we're waiting for Tina and getting deeper into the structure and the finance, what my uncles were on the board on the were the governors of this project initially before it was just farmland.
所以等一下呢 ，Tina 会介绍更多的结构呢，跟那个种植的相关的事情。但之前呢，其实我的叔叔呢，就是在政府那边有去谈那个种植这一块。
The power companies were back then 100% owned by the government.
那时候的电厂是100%是政府持有。
They negotiated a offtake agreement with a floor price for the power.
那政府呢？后来同意的是呢，它是承购价呢，是真的是用正常价格，也就是原价收购。
So they had guarantees from the power company, which enabled them to go to the bank and borrow against the future power.
因为政府有这样的一个承诺，所以呢，他们就可以去银行谈。这样子的话，银行就可以说哦，因为未来有这个钱，然后也有这个合约，有这样的一个保证的承购价，所以他愿意借钱给他们盖电厂。
That sort of debt structuring, though, is one-off. It would be very unlikely to get a 100% debt finance project like that again.
那这样子的一个这个融资呢，是几乎是100%提供，但是现在呢，要继续这样子，其实也不太容易。
So most of the more recent geothermal developments are in partnership with either onshore or international investors.
所以，因为这样子呢，所以现在几乎大多数的地热资源的这个开发跟电厂的开发都是合伙的关系，要不是跟国内或者是国际的厂商合作。
But we can talk all day on that. That's we can talk on that later and tomorrow and the next day.
那但是呢，这块就可以谈很久，所以今天我有时间或者是明天、后天的时候都可以再谈。
在座与会的朋友们，大家好啊！我是太麻里乡乡民代表，也是住在金伦部落哈。我是想要请教的是，目前我们金伦溪流域就是我的家乡，有4家电厂要准备进驻，其中有一家已经在发电1年了，他连回馈机制都还没有提，我真羡慕你们国家真好。因为是原住民地区，所以我们有原基法21条，私有地排除在外，但是地底下的资源是照理来讲是大家共同共有的，结果我们这个国家哦。真的是听到你们国家这么好，我感觉到这个国家真的真烂，把原住民的权益全部都剥夺了，连个回馈机制都没有。我看我搬去你那个国家比较好。谢谢，以上。
我们了解各位在台湾这边碰到的问题。
我们纽西兰的 Kira， 对吧？家人，我不一样。我是来自，我跟刚才那个代表是同一个部落。我是那里的村长。那首先我非常的认同，就是纽西兰在对这个地热开发的这个理念，跟我的理念是非常。一样的，就是在部落开发里面，我们最重要的其实还是首先要先尊重 我们部落的人的这个人的意愿哈。那我首先有三个问题想要请教一下我们的这个听啊这边，就是说他们部落是由厂商去做这个主要的开发，还是是政府来去做开发？那这是第一点哈。然后第二个事情呢，那在这件事情上面哦，纽西兰政府哦，就是在做这个地热开发的时候，纽西兰政府在部落或者是在这个开发商之间，纽西兰政府它是扮演什么样的角色？然后又是怎么样的在部落里面，可能来帮部落来去做这个协调，或者是以帮助，这是第二点。那第三点，我想问，他们部落里面哦，在做这个地热开发的时候，最初在做地热开发的时候，有没有产生自己部落里面内部的可能意见的不同，或者是对立？那有这样子的发生的事情的话，他们是怎么样去解决这样子的矛盾？啊，这是我想要听到他们的分享的。啊，以上，谢谢。
I'll start with the last question first.
我先从最后一个问题开始。
So, very strong tribal leadership over a long period of time to get everyone comfortable with the development of our ancestor, our geothermal resource, our ancestor.
所以是真的是部落的领导呢，非常强大的，然后非常努力，一段时间，长期一段时间，让部落的大家真的都很自在，觉得说要开发这个祖先的地热资源，他们是愿意的。
The other half of that is, if we didn't participate, they would have done it anyway.
而且另外一部分也是说，就算如果我们不参与这个地热资源的开发，其他人也会这么做。
So the government is the regulator.
那政府呢，就是监管者。
The, as I said, the two big enablers was one, getting our indigenous rights recognized in the Resource Management Act.
那第一个呢，当然就是我们刚刚讲到的，就是在资源管理法里面呢，原住民的权利呢是有被认可肯认的。
And as you could see, that was 1992.
而且各位可以看到的是1992年立的法。
The government then privatized part of the energy companies. They listed them on the share market.
那再呢，另外是就是电力公司有部分私有化，然后进到市场。
It used to be one national power company.It got broken down into about 6 different power companies in different regions, and then they sold them off. Part of them off. The government still has a controlling shareholding.
Okay, 好，那原本呢是一个国有的这一个国营的这个电厂，那不好意思是电力公司。那政府呢把它分成六个不同的个电力公司，然后分布在不同的区域内，然后接着呢又把部分的股权卖出。当然，政府还是持有大多数的股权。
That created a competitive energy electricity pricing environment.
但也因为这样子呢，所以电力就会有竞争的一个环境跟市场。
And then the ability for us to negotiate with those power companies.
那也因为这样呢，给了我们不同的空间，跟这些电力的公司进行协商谈判。
What?
可以吗？
I think just in response to the last question, it's not easy bringing your people on the journey.
那稍微回答一下最后一个问题，就刚才讲到冲突这个问题，其实要带着自己的族人走向这个旅程，其实不容易。
They are the most important stakeholder for you, yet they are the ones most emotional around you, regarding when you've got challenges like this environmentally.
那他们对你来说呢，会是你最重要的利害关系人，但是同时在他们面对你的时候，当然也是情绪最满的时候。所以，尤其是特别讲到的是跟他们息息相关，又是环境的问题。
Strong leadership, strong communication, and strong vision, and connecting your people to it will be part of your solutions.
没错。 也许部分的解决方案是真的要非常强而有力的领导，非常强而有力的沟通能力，跟非常强而有力的一个愿景。
We've done some good things as Maori people in New Zealand, but it's still hard.
就算在纽西兰，我们毛利族做的毛利人做的很多部分都已经很不错，但是这样子还是非常困难。
But we're here to support you with continually telling you what we've done and achieved, and even how we might be able to support or help you here in Taiwan.
但我们就是来这里支持各位的，所以我们可以跟各位一路上去分享说我们在纽西兰做到了什么，我们目前达到了什么样的成果。那同时也一路上看看说在纽西兰这边我们可以提供台湾什么样的支持。
I'm sure there'll be other questions to come. I'll quickly go through my presentation so we can continue the dialogue because I think that's the most important part.
那我知道说大家可能还会有一些问题，但我就很快跟大家介绍一下我的简报。等一下呢，再给留给时间给大家问问题。我觉得问题才是最重要的。
Well, kia ora. These are my tribes down here: Ngāti Tūkorohe, Ngāti Raukawa ki Te Ōtonga, Maupoko, Ngāti Rārawa, Rangitāne. Five tribes.
那这个是我来自的部落，五个部落。
So I'm from here.
所以我是来自这一块。
Timuera is from here.
Tim 呢是来自于上面那一块。
And we fight often.
我们常常打架。
We don't have geothermal where I'm from, but I've managed in my career to see a lot of the geothermal transactions.
那我们自己这一块呢，其实并不是做地热，主要是做种植的。但是我看过很多地热的这个开发。
This is where I'm from. That's my mountain, Tararua. There is my river, Oho, out to my lands for Ngāti Tūkorohe to our ocean. We have different challenges.We are fighting golf courses being developed on our sacred lands.
那这个呢是我来自的地方，可以看到这边是我们的山，然后河流，然后一路流下去，流到了海边。那我们自己呢要面对的是不同的挑战。我们的挑战呢是在我们的圣地那边呢要盖高尔夫球场。
And this is one of my tribal homes where I was born and raised, and that house is our ancestor. That is Tūkorohe. That house is Tūkorohe.
We name the houses
after the ancestors.
那这个呢，是我们以前的这个长大的这个家。那这我们的房子的命名呢，就是用我们的祖先来帮它命名的，所以它的名字在这边。
And I live about here.
那我大概住在这边。
Okay, so rangatiratanga, mana mutuhake, they are two words that Timuera has spoken about. Rangatiratanga.Is sovereignty of your people, self autonomy of your people. Mana mutuhake is your own determination.
那上面这两个 rana tiga tanga 跟 mana tuharante k 是刚刚的 team 其实都有提到的，一个呢是我们自己自主的主权的这个权利，另外一个呢是自己决定的自觉权。
I think I might have gone the wrong way on my presentation. Oh, okay. And in our tribal structures, just so you've got an idea, when we talk about tribe, this is what it makes up. An iwi is a tribe. A hapu is sub-tribe. So lots of sub-tribes make up an iwi.
好，那我们在讲到部落的结构的时候，稍微给你讲一下我们的结构大概长什么样子。一个 iwi 呢，就是我们刚刚讲的一个部落。那在一个 hapu 呢，基本上就是这个分支分子部落。
Lots of family groupings make up a hapu，
所以呢是有很多的家庭啊群全部聚集在一起，最后呢组成一个 hapu。
And I'm one member of a family。
那我呢也是我自己家庭的其中一个成员。
So Tim has already spoken to you about our connection to geothermal. Māori people, we do not put people at the center of our story. We put the environment.
那Tim 呢已经跟各位说，我们跟地热毛利人跟地热之间的关系。毛利人呢不会把人放在我们故事的中心，我们把环境放在我们故事的中心。
The importance of that gives us the responsibility as guardians.
所以呢，这最重要的就是我们作为禁止管理者，作为 guardians， 我们管理者、守护者，我们的责任是什么
？Tim spoke about intergenerational guardianship.
Tim 呢讲到的是世世代代、跨世代的这种禁止管理的守护。
So we're thinking about seven generations of that's what that looks like. So we have to think long term, but act fast.
我们所以呢，我们要想的是至少七个世代的，所以我们要想的是长期，但是要很快的想出这些东西。
You've already heard about start to steam. So when there's exploration, then the drilling, then building of the power plant. So that gives you the steam.
那各位已经知道说一开始的时候怎么拿到一些蒸汽，一开始先有探勘，然后再来是钻孔钻井了以后呢，接着的那个水蒸气就会上来，你就会拿到它你要的水蒸气。
And you heard most also about re-injection, and that's actually a critical part. As we know, you've got the water resource that then gets back and recycled through the geothermal system.
那当然，你们听到说刚刚怎么去介绍说这个水呢？最后在进行热交换之后呢，我们怎么样又把它注回去？这样的水就可以持续循环。
I've spoken at lots of geothermal conferences and seminars, and everyone always wants to know about structure, and we think.This is something that you could be looking to put in place.
那我在很多地热的论坛啊，或者是研讨会都有发言过。那其实很多人都想要知道是整个结构上要怎么样去运作。我想各位可能对这个也有点兴趣。
So what happens next with the potential opportunity that there is a geothermal development going to take place in your tribal homelands? What's the primary development, and then what is the secondary development use? And Tim's already spoken to a couple of those.
那基本上呢，通常如果可能是在部落的这个地方要进行开发的时候呢，它有初级的开发，也有可能是次级使用的开发。那 Tim 呢，刚刚有讲到是次级使用的开发。
We want you to be able to participate if you want to in the geothermal development story, but it does cost money, and so who's there to support you with capital assets?
那我们当然希望说，在地热开发的整个过程中呢，各位能够有所参与，在这个故事中是有你们存在的。但是当然这是需要钱的，所以谁来支持这个钱跟资本
？So what's the role of government? You ask. Well, the government has some potential opportunities to support you here, as well as the non-government organisations, those that are quite financially capable.
那所以刚刚有提问到说，那政府的角色是什么？政府在这里就可以扮演一些角色，协助各位进行开发。但另外一个不是政府以外的角色，其实也是有钱的人，这些有钱的人也可以在中间扮演一些角色。
Okay, so the other key things are to fully understand what your concerns are about this and be able to articulate it. So.
好，再来另外一件事情就是你要具体的知道说你们担忧的地方是什么，你们的问题是什么，然后清楚的说出来。
We know that there's a bigger objective at play. Taiwan wants power sovereignty. It wants to make sure it's got renewable energies as part of its energy portfolio.
那我们都知道，在最上面的政府政策面来说，第一个台湾要能源自主，第二个呢是我们希望是再生能源。
And there is no doubt about it that green energy or green options are better than the alternatives.
那当然，大家都不需要辩驳的，就是绿色能源当然比它的替代能源是好的。
And then there's this thing called indigenous rights. That's another one of the issues. How do you maintain indigenous rights? And Tim has spoken to you about some of the Māori components that we've experienced.
那再来另外又一个面向呢，是原住民权，以及要怎么样去维持维护你的原住民权。那 Tim 呢，刚刚有稍微讲到说毛利的面向他们怎么去做，还有一些组成成分。
And then the notion that this will probably take place regardless of where you are in that decision making process. So how do you get in front of the decision making process and be an active participant in those decisions?
那以及刚刚有讲到说，如果我们不去参与的话，其他人可能也会还是这么做。所以既然是这样子的话，那你要怎么样站在决策的前面，然后真的更积极主动的参与这整个决策的过程
？What are the actual concerns inside the tribal township? I've heard a lot about how current livelihoods could be affected. Our enterprises could be affected if we're reliant on geothermal and tourism.Our lifestyle could then be affected because we're not bringing in enough money into our local region, so we might have to move, and our cultural practices also may be affected.
那在部落里面，很多时候在讨论的时候，可能会出现的一些问题跟担忧是，譬如说可能生计会受到影响啊，或者是我本来的一些公司啊，或者是营运的方式，其实仰赖不管是观光产业啊，还是其他的产业，会不会受到影响？我们原本的生活的模式跟习惯会不会受到影响？如果地热并没有带来像我们这么好赚这种获利的资源的话，那是不是代表说我要搬迁他处？然后再来是我们文化惯习会不会受到影响？
So they also become your drivers now. So how do you then use that and articulate that to make sure that people understand? There might be more, but what are the concerns that are important to you?
那当然，这些东西你原本的问题跟担忧跟疑虑，最后就会变成你的驱动力。你要怎么样清楚的表现出来，具体的说出来说你们的担忧是什么，对你们来说重要的地方是什么？当然，也许这个清单不止这样，但是要清楚的把它讲出来。
And then what are the other levers that might be supporting you through that? In our case, we have asset ownership, but that might be different to you here, as we know.
那还有哪一些手段是你可以去善用的？譬如说，在毛利的这个情况下，是他们有资产，他们有土地的所有权。但我知道说，在台湾可能情况不太一样。
Positive political relationships. I think that's one that's very alive and well here in Taiwan.
那还有呢，跟政府的关系良好，我想在这里呢这一块可能已经很不错，而且非常的蓬勃发展。
And then there are other levers: further education, workforce participation, ownership potential, and then guardianship for those future generations.
那当然还有一些其他的面向，有一些其他的手段，比如说进步的教育啊，劳动力的一些投入啊，或者是可能潜在的所有权，或者是为了下一个世代的这个守护权。
In New Zealand, for Māori, we had to lead ourselves. So this has to be a people-led approach, Māori-led, government-enabled. That would be one of the recommendations we would have for you, Indigenous, tribal-led, government-enabled. But you have to be able to tell the government what you want.
那在毛利呢，基本上是他们是由人为带领去进行这样的一个开发的。我想，这也许可以是提供给台湾这边的建议，就是由部落这边进行带领，然后政府是协助促成这样的一个发展。那但是呢，非常重要一点就是你必须要清楚的告诉政府是你需要的是什么，你要政府怎么做。
And this might be where you bring in your cousins from Aotearoa New Zealand to come and help drive those conversations alongside you.
那这呢，也许就是可以这时候呢，善用你的亲戚，也就是在纽西兰的从Aotearoa纽西兰这边来，大家呢去带着他们，去带着他们给政府看，告诉他们说你们需要的是什么。
Then how do you represent yourselves? How do you set yourself up for the best engagement and spearhead through all of the different parties that you have to talk to?
然后再来呢，是你要怎么样去呈现自己？你要怎么样把自己的想法表达出来？你怎样去跟面对各个不同的利害关系人？
I'm sure you're thinking about this. This is not news to you.
我相信这些大家都已经非常熟悉了，这不是新的观念。
Tim's already spoken to our connection and our journey, so we care about you because we came from here. This is home.
那所以 Tim 已经讲过说这个所有的旅程一切，所以我们非常在乎各位，因为各位对我们来说就是家。
And then Tim's also spoken about our navigational priorities to the south, how we were entrepreneurs and enterprise orientated. In the 1830s, 1860s, we got colonized. That quickly changed our landscape. And then now we're in quite a different situation.
那 Tim 刚刚也讲到的是，在整个一路南下的过程中，他们怎么样进行探索，怎么样其实从一直以来呢就是创业家，就是企业家，但是在这个过程中，一路到了1830年代的时候，开始被打断，又开始被殖民了。
And so up here, and this is the same for most indigenous communities across the world. What's important? We want access to knowledge. We want to have access to our resources. Tourism is the gateway to demonstrate who we are and our unique approach.Education and health are the things that are most important for us to thrive.
那这个呢，其实也是世界各地原住民面对的情况。我们想要的是什么？我们想要的是我们的这个知识的这个传统。我们要的是可能透过是观光去最容易呈现出我们自己，让大家知道我们的文化是什么，我们的习惯做法是什么。再来透过教育，我们要健康，这些都是我们希望的。
So we had different types of protests and different types of resistance for our Renaissance.By no means am I saying do what we did, but you can see how we had a majority of land ownership, quickly surpassed down to not having very much at all. So we understand the pain of loss, and then we understand the pain to fight for what is your rights.
那这个呢一路上呢，我们做了非常多的抗争。那这也是试着想要复兴我们的传统。那当然，我们绝对不是说是就做着我们照着我们的路走。但是你可以看到，从上面原本我们持有这么多的土地，到下面我们的持有的土地变得这么少，所以你可以了解的是这些损失、这些失去的这些痛苦。
So one of the little tricks we did was that we educated our people, and then we made sure that they worked inside the government. They were on the bus.And the right seat on the bus to help drive change that was going to affect us.
那所以我们做的事情呢，就是我们让确保我们的下一代有好好的受到教育，然后确保他们进到政府里面工作，然后在政府里面去带动整个政治的推广。
We have to understand our statistics and how we're thriving as a people. And it doesn't take long to get momentum. You know, 7 years worth of generation long.But it doesn't take long before you become quite relevant to, you know, your island and where you live. So we understand our tribal registries. We know where our people are, and we can account for them. It's still very difficult if they live outside of your region or offshore. We then have the national registry of Māori population.And then, so all of those types of statistics and data are equally important to making sure you can represent your indigenous collective approach to this.
那再来呢是其实数字也是非常的重要，我们把这些数字、这些统计全部都好好的记起来，这样我们才能够知道记起这个世代。有时候就想到是世世代代，七个世代也许很长，但是事实上很短啊，它也真的是很一下子就紧密的连接到你自己所在所处的这个岛屿里面。所以我们有一个国家的这个注册处，基本上呢就是每一个毛利的一个登记跟记录。那也许在离岛或是比较 其他的一个小岛屿的地方呢，在记录上可能会比较困难，但是我们很努力的确保说我们把这些数字都记下来。
New Zealand Māori economy now is growing 5 times more than the mainstream New Zealand economy.But we've got a couple of other tools that you don't have. We have that treaty, we have the ability to renegotiate our well-being.
那这边可以看到是毛利的经济成长率比起纽西兰整体的经济成长率是快上5倍的。那当然这代表是其实相较于各位我们是有刚刚讲到的这个条约，我们有刚刚有其他的工具可以使用。
We've got a holistic approach to our worldview, so it's very environmentally led.And our people will be the majority of the working population of New Zealand. We are 17% of New Zealand's population compared to our cousins here who are about 2 to 3%.
那我们用全方面的一个面向，然后去确保说整个发展呢是用环境为导向的，用我们部落的人为根基的。那但是我知道说我们的这个整个背景跟脉络还是有差。毛利人大概占纽西兰人口的17%，我知道说在台湾原住民的比例大概是2-3%。
So our problems are very similar, but they're not quite the same. So we need to work out how to solve your ones.
所以我们知道说我们面对的问题可能是类似，但是并不完全一样，所以我们可能要一起努力去想一想，说我们要怎么解决各位的问题。
Over here, these are common things that Tim will often talk about in the work that he does. This is mainstream Western non-Indigenous worldview, and over here we've got our Indigenous perspectives. So they are mainstream is more individually orientated, personal self-wealth.
那我们来看一下，这也是 Team 他们常常要面对的、看到的。其实，在主流这边，我们有主流的想法、主流的一些意见、主流主要的一些观点。右边呢是原住民的这些观点，所以主流你可以看到是比较个别主义的。
Versus Indigenous will be group orientated. We think of the collective.
然后个人主义，然后个人的资产，个人的财产。那原住民呢比较是团体的、集体的。
Single generation, so mainstream companies will say, yes, we're also intergenerational, but it's the understanding of what that means from an Indigenous perspective and a mainstream perspective.
那再来是他们想的可能是单一世代的，所以就算公司可能跟你说这个东西的发展是跨世代的，你要了解在主流上面跨世代是什么意思，跟原住民想的跨世代可能不太一样。
Individual competitiveness, so I want to be the best and be at the top.Versus the collaborative, collective well-being.
那再来呢是个别主义，然后跟比较竞争主义，就是我要一路跑到最上面，成为最好的。相较于是整个集体性的一起的。
In these situations, it's the collaborative, collective well-being that is going to be your superpower, but it's one of the hardest things to actually put in place.
所以其实对于各位部落大家来说的话，协作、合作、集体会是各位的超能力，但同时也是最难达到的地方。
Our drivers are probably very similar to yours. Education, critical age, working age, where are they going to participate in that workforce?
那比如说，在我们的驱动力呢，可能跟各位部落的大家非常类似。在教育上面来说，这些学龄的阶层跟工作的阶层等等，他们的时机是什么？
Creating jobs and employment in our own region so that you don't have to leave your families and go far away.
那再来是在自己的区域内就能够创造工作跟就业的机会，这样的话大家不用离乡背井，非常的对。
Wealth and health of people, environmental guardianship。
那再来呢是人民的财产啊跟健康啊，还有环境的这个保护、管理、守护的责任。
Value add to the resources that you do have。
然后再来呢是针对你自己本来已有的资源呢，能够是增加价值的。
Making it better for the next generation,
让下一个世代更好。
And then we do that forever.
而且呢，我们是永远这样子做。
So this is kind of how we look at it, and I'm sure it will be similar in your families. Relationships, values-driven, intergenerational, regional, provincial, so localized, complex. Our structures are complex. We'll show you them.Willingness to collaborate, structures, legislation that is actually relevant for you as a participant, and then the guardianship. We don't think profit as being the first cab off the rank. We want more than profit.
那再来是这个呢，是我们会共享的。那我相信对各位来说，应该也是非常类似的。最上面这边一路到右，然后到成一个圈，包括的是关系，然后还有是以价值为驱动力的。我们想的是世世代代的事情。我们有区域的，有省份之间的，但同时又出又落化到在地上怎么样去进行落实。我们有非常复杂的治理系统跟整个结构这一块呢，我们等一下也会跟大家介绍。再来呢，是我们彼此的关系是合作的、协作的。那再来是结构跟法规的部分这一块呢，也会跟各位有所关系。好，再来是同时我们也认为说，我们是这个土地、这个资源的守护者，守护的身份有守护的责任。这也代表了说，对我们来说，获利并不是最重要的。
And so we rely heavily on relationships in regards to landowners slash developers. We look for sustainable win-win propositions and solutions. Doesn't mean that we're not commercially capable or able, but we want to make sure that it's not at the expense of things that are important to us.
所以这代表的是呢，土地的所有者跟开发商之间其实是要建立起非常强、非常有力的、非常好的一个关系。但同时呢，我们在永续上面，我们希望是能够达到双赢，每个人都能够赢的这个立场。然后再来是这，商业也许并不是我们最大的考量，但不代表说我们就没有办法获利。我们只是想说，我们并不是把商业、把获利放在最上面，我们需要的是互动，真实的就是我们会想到的是其他的面向。
We often talk about access to capital. As soon as you say you're indigenous, you're already more higher risk than other people who are not.
那我们讲到的是获得资本这件事情，光是原住民这个身份，其实就代表是你获得资本的风险就是比较高了。
But capital is more than just money. Capital is, you know, having the right people around you.
资本代表的不只是钱，是你周围要是对的人。
So our structures, Taiwan has sent people down, I think Council of Indigenous Peoples has commissioned some work to look at our New Zealand Māori structures. We inherited a lot of them because of our governing government at the time, so we had a lot of legislation that we weren't co-designers of.
那在结构上来讲的话呢，我知道说原民会其实有派人跟我们一起坐下来，稍微去研究一下整个毛利这个结构跟相关的地方。那毛利之所以有这样的一个结构，也是因为当时的政府呢，其实跟我们一起坐下来，然后去一起立法。
It's got onions at the top because it's a really complicated onion. It's a layer upon a layer upon a layer. But once you start peeling back the layer, you get right to the nub of what's going to be relevant.
那我最上面呢放了一个洋葱在上面，主要是因为它是非常复杂，还有一层一层一层之间的关系。但是你一旦层层的剥下去以后，你就可以拿到中间的这个核心，重点是什么？
These are a range of the different types of structures and entities we have in New Zealand.
这个呢，在纽西兰的我们在纽西兰的实体里面呢，其实有类似有分成这几个各种不同的结构架构。
And these are the ones that Māori people utilize for their business perspectives. We have Māori land trusts, so that you have to be of those family hapū iwi, and then be part of that grouping of people who've been assigned that land.
那所以基这也是就是毛利人在商业的模式上面会使用的。所以左边第一个呢，就是毛利的土地信托，基本上呢就是你必须要是这个iwi，就是这个部落底下的这个家庭，然后你们在这个部落里面，然后一起拥有这块土地。
We have Māori incorporations. They're similar to land trusts, but they are collective groups that have incorporated together to make a bigger collaboration or collective.
那另外呢，我们也有毛利，有点类似一起合力的这种公司组成的公司，基本上有点像是土地信托，但是基本上就是有更多更多的毛利的部落呢，一起呢聚在一起，变成是更大的一大块的公司。
In the middle, we have tribal bodies or iwi bodies. These were partly co-designed with Māori, and they were based on post-treaty settlement asset reclamations.
那这再来在中间呢，我们有iwi的这个机构，基本上就是部落的这个机构。那他们基本上呢是在协约之后呢，我们一起坐下来讨论的。
So they are large and represent future generations.These are more smaller collectives or individual family groupings into trusts, and probably represent the view of the people more so.
那中间这个呢，基本上是选出来，然后代表是毛利人，然后在左边这两边呢是比较小型的，然后比较像是合作社模式这样一个一个这样加总出来，代表是他们那边的一个利益。
Iwi collectives over here are when multiple tribes coalesce on things.They unite on things.
那再来呢是iwi的 collective， 基本上就是各个不同的部落呢，他们可能呢在某些事情上面会团结起来，所以这个是他们有一起有 collectives.
Tim's a good person to talk about for that one. Our forestry assets, our seafood assets are good examples. And then pan-tribal organizations.
那所以呢Tim 呢刚也非常适合去谈，我们在讲到资产的时候呢，不管是水产资产还是其他的资产，他都可以谈这一块。好，再来最后呢还有整个是泛毛利的一个组织。
So they're recognized entities, they kind of could be NGOs, they could be lobbying groups, etc. which you form a membership basis.
那基本上呢比较是有可能是 NGO 啊或者是游说团体。
So knowing all of that,This story is pretty intense for us as well.
所以现在大家也都知道，这个对我们来说，我们整个抗争的这个故事呢，其实也是非常的困难的。
This is a typical risk scale for investment, and for us as Māori people who own those assets or have those assets, many of the assets are not producing very well. We were highly exposed to risk, regardless of any financial support.
所以你可以看到是我们在资产的这一个风险这个层级上面，可以看到很多毛利人所拥有的这个资产呢，第一个它可能生产力本来就不高了，所以在提供融资的这个铺险上面，他们算是非常高风险的。
And this one, so this might be your tribal bodies or your groups back in the villages or the townships, but over here is where we're talking about these other geothermal developments, high risk.It's right up there, and it requires other parties to be involved.
那左下角呢，可能是你们一般的部落啊，可能不管是部落层级啊、村层级啊，或者乡镇层级。那右上角呢，可能就是我们刚刚讲到的这种地热的资源的开发，它可能需要那含入很多的利害关系人，然后风险相对就比较高。
And that could be scary for people if you don't educate them and get them fully on board to be part of the journey, no matter where you participate in the scale.
那如果呢，对大家来说，要大家来参与这样的一个这么高层级、这么高风险的一个这个投资呢？其实对大家来说，如果他们并没有完全了解的话，对于弗洛人来说，其实还蛮可怕的。
Cool. Let's talk about more happier stories rather than risk. What are the alternative uses that are there for geothermal? And Tim spoke about some of them, but we've put it on a scale here so you can see. Here is the temperature. These are the different types of industry it could be used for.
那在我们先不讲风险这一块，我们先回来到地热它本身的这个应用上面。也听已经讲说几个地热资源的应用，但是如果我们直接把它放到一个屏幕上面，我们来看一下它的各种的不同的应用。除了直接供电以外，它其实还有很多不同的使用方式。
Darby and Basalt, they spoke about binary geothermal plants, flash and dry steam geothermal energy production.
那刚刚呢，其实在左边这个发电这一块呢，已经有讲到是双循环制度啊，或者是直接的这个蒸汽这个发电，或者是闪蒸的这个制度。
But there's an array of other types of things you can do. Geothermal heat pumps, they could be in your households in those communities, which you might already use. Green housing, fabric dyeing, refrigeration, and ice making.
好，那除了就是刚刚直接使用的发电以外，其实你可以看到还是很有一些用法是可以直接也是可以用这个地热的这个资源的。譬如说下面有关的是你们自己家家户户搞不好已经有在使用的这种地热的放浦，直接使用它的那个供热。然后再来呢，还有是刚刚讲到的染色，再来还有的是譬如说，
we've also got aquaculture. We've already looked at what Tim showed you around the prawn farm.That could potentially be another enterprise that you could embark upon, as well as paper and pulp drying processes.
那另外呢，有讲到刚刚是温室的这个种植也都可以使用，然后另外还有是 Tim 刚刚有提到是水产的养殖，譬如说刚刚讲到的养虾场。那另外这边有列出来，譬如说纸浆的制造加工也可以使用。
We've already talked about tourism and bathing potential.Timber drying, there's a lot of forests that we see here, so you could be doing timber drying kilns.
那再来呢，我们也刚刚有提到说，比如说观光产业啊，跟泡汤啊。那再来的是，通常在地热资源这附近可能会有一些森林林木嘛，那我们也可以想到的是，譬如说如果砍伐了以后呢，我们可以在那边去晒干那些木材。
We've already spoken about food production, so fruit and vegetable greenhouses.With the steam energy, but you could also use it for drying and preserving.
那透过蒸汽的加热呢，我们当然可以刚刚已经提到，不管是水果啊，或者蔬果的这些温室的种植，但同时也可以拿来做干燥。
And then there's other biofuels you could be producing off the back of geothermal. And then there's also one that's not on there, which is more current now, which is mineral extraction, depending on what is the composition in your waters.
那再来呢，另外有讲到的是我们可能在地热资源的同时使用，同时也可以有生殖燃料的一些生产，还有一个是可能最近开始使用，可能相对目前比较少使用的，就是根据你那边的水质，你萃取出来的水是什么呢，你可以做出一些矿物质的这个分离。
This is just to give you a bit of a lens on the footprint. Some of the presentations have already touched on this, but they can be low level or else they can be high.The challenge with Taiwan is that you don't have a lot of space for them, so you've got to design the right engineering that suits this environment.
那刚刚之前前面你就有提到说，就是大概整个地热的这个地热电厂大概的占地是多少？那这个刚刚照片就是给大家稍微看一下，它可以是比较低的，也可以是相对的是比较高的。那以台湾来讲的话，我们的地幅员其实不太大，所以我们可能要想到是要怎么样有正确的工程去做适合台湾的发电。
So they were just other examples of what it can look like in different terrain, and in the Philippines, in Malaysia, that we've actually helped. So New Zealand's got high quality knowledge around how to build and produce power plants. And we do have Māori companies that are part of that supply chain.
那这边也可以看到是，就是不同的地形，它可能适合的是不同的工程跟不同的建筑。可以看到，如果去参考马来西亚或是菲律宾的地方的话，其实也会有很好的这个不同的一些做法。那纽西兰其实对于整个地热资源跟电厂的开发的知识非常的丰沛，这也是为什么其实甚至有毛利的公司呢，就有参与这些其他电厂的开发。
Tim Werner has already spoken about this particular case study, which is one of our incorporations.To Arapaki.
那这个呢 ，Tim 刚刚有介绍到的这一个公司叫做 To Arapaki.
It's quite interesting because that whole footprint takes into place their farms as well as their geothermal and all the other side production they have.
那蛮有趣的是，因为它这整个占地呢，其实就有包括是他们的农地呀、啊，然后还有包括的是整个就是电厂啊，然后还有一些生产的空间。
So this is one we love particularly because it's using the steam, so you can produce food for your people at the end of the day, and then the quantities are up to you depending on size.
那这个呢是非常有趣的一个利用，也就是说它生产出来的这个水蒸气又可以再拿利用。作为就是农作物的这些温室农作物的这些种植，那当然它生产的量呢，就是根据你这边温室的这个大小可以
But they also have farms. So here over here we've got Māori land, which grows Māori grass with Māori cows, produce Māori milk. The Māori milk will come to the Māori dairy factory.
那再来这边可以看到，蛮有趣的事情，很多时候在这边电也可以在农地上面使用，譬如说这边是右边呢是毛利的土地，生产是毛利的草，上面养的是毛利的牛，这些毛利的牛最后会生毛利的牛奶，毛利的牛奶就会送到毛利的牛乳厂。
They take the waste product from the Māori dairy factory and feed it to the worms.
然后再来呢，把这一个牛乳厂弄出来的这个废物呢，废物料呢，再把它去喂给这个虫。
They take the nutrient from the worms and put it back on the Māori land for the Māori grass.
那再把这个虫呢，最后生产出来的这个营养物质呢，最后再丢回这个毛利的土地上面，最后养出了更多的毛利的草。
So this is quite sophisticated, but it can demonstrate the circular economy that you're thinking about.For when you might want to participate in whatever is relevant for Taiwan.
这算是一个蛮成熟的一个循环跟使用跟应用的。但是如果各位想要参与的话，这会是其中一个循环经济各位可以考虑的。
Here's another one of our tribal lands trusts. So the last one was in a corporation. This is a lands trust.
那刚刚那个呢介绍的是公司，这个呢介绍的是土地信托。
They are similar. They own a lot of geothermal power stations. We're seven times larger than Taiwan.
那在这其实跟他们蛮类似的，他们一样是拥有非常多的这个地热电厂，那可能是比台湾的还要大。
That's not the driver. That's utilizing that asset, but they're also focused on making sure they've got land for their people, food for the people, and then other types of jobs for the people through tourism.
但是呢，这个并不是他们主要使用的这个动力，他们也要去确，主要的驱动力是要确保说那边部落人民他们的土地的使用，他们有食物能够确保那边的工作，那边的观光能够继续发展。
In those greenhouses, this is back in Rotorua where Tim Werner first spoke about. We have co-joint ventures, Māori people investing with other mainstream investors.Into greenhouses, and they produce a huge quantity of export quality type flowers.
那这个呢例子呢，其实就是Tim刚刚有提到，就是第一个那个温室的这个温室花的这个这个例子。基本上它是一个合资的公司，就是毛利人跟其他人进行伙伴的合作关系，他们可以生产非常大量的花，出口到各地。
I'm not showing you these to show how great we, you know, Māori people are. It's actually just to show you that there's alternative other side and secondary uses that you could also be participants in through the indigenous geothermal development.
我们给各位看这些东西，并不是只是告诉各位说毛利人做的好棒棒，而是要告诉大家说，其实有这样的一些不同的替代方式，除了发电厂以外，电厂以外另外的使用还是在土地上，根据你的规模，根据你的大小，根据你们想要的，可以有不同的应用。
We have a lot of forests, so drying wood is quite an important one for us. But I think there's quite a bit of forestry that takes place here in Taiwan. So these were the drying of the processed forestry.
那我们有非常多的森林，所以林业对我们来说也非常的重要。那把这个林木弄干燥也非常的重要，所以这也是我们其中一块会有的应用。那也要看说台湾的林业的发展适不适合。
Tim Luna has already spoken to you about this enterprise.
那这个企业这个养虾场也刚刚跟各位分享过了。
And then these are some of the aligned businesses that sit around that. So we've got geothermal pools, very similar to what happens here.
那其实另外呢，也有一些就是跟地热资源相关的一些应用跟这个产业，包括是温泉，其实跟台湾这边的类似应用非常类似。
This one we're using geothermal other byproducts, like it could be mud or water or those minerals, which are then part of a high value massage or a spa treatment.
那这个呢，我们用的是地热发电的这一个副产品，也是可能不管是水啊，或者是泥土啊，或者是矿物质啊，基本上呢都可以拿来做的是，就是这种非常高价值、高品质的这种按摩的这个使用的东西。
And I think Taiwan is very, very good, and our indigenous people are already very good at doing all of those things.
那我知道台湾在这边，尤其是原住民这边的伙伴，已经做的非常好了。
So we come back to those original questions.What are the issues you're trying to solve? What are you concerned about? What are your drivers? What are your levers? And then how do you set yourself up?
那这个一样是就是我回到我们一开始原本的问题，你们觉得问题在哪里？对你们来说担忧、担心的是什么？对你们来说驱动力又是什么？你们有哪一些手法、有些哪一些手段可以运用？你要怎么样把自己呈现出来
？So I was just playing around earlier, hence I was late putting my slides up to look at. Well, what could it look like?If you were thinking about that participation model. Over here, we've got government, national and local, you know, they're responsible across whatever layer of entity you are. At the top, we have our lobbyist groups, they're responsible no matter who you are in the equation. You could be in partnership with multiple tribal entities, but you have to have an entity in order to do something collective.This once you get to one entity, you could then set, depending on what your social drivers are, your cultural, environmental, or commercial goals are, these could be the arms to your entity. You could have more than one subsidiary company.
好，那再来呢？是因为刚刚有在想说到底要什么样的模式，所以这最后一刻我才再用简报再会拉一下这张图，就是给大家想象一下，到底最后这些不同的利害关系人可以是什么样的关系跟互动。从最左边我们可以看到是政府面，不管是中央政府还是地方政府，它会跟所有的利害关系人都有所连接，所以这个是整个横向，所有全部都有所连接的。在最上面可能是游说团体，游说团体可能会影响到所有人。接下来呢，我们可以看到的是可能有不同的这些可能原住民会整个聚落集合在一起的这一种机构。那当然呢，可能代表是各个不同的实体，你可能跟不同人进行互动。那当然你自己本身必须要是一个实体，真的要集体在一起，你自己也才有力量，才能跟其他人进行互动。那根据你自己呢，下面你可能会有不同的驱动力。对你来说，到底驱动力的是环境因素、文化因素、社会因素还是商业因素？它会造成一些不同的一些影响。那在下面呢，可能又有一些不同的子公司出现。
What you could have joint venture companies with other parties. They could be other indigenous or outside groups.
那你可能呢？可能是跟其他人合伙做成立合资的公司，所以你可能是跟其他部落的人合作，也有可能是跟外面的人合作。
What's missing on here though is who's there to support you. So we've got lobby, we've got government, but on the other side could be financing or access to capital.
那在这边呢，我没有写到呢是谁可以作为你们的支持者，所以我们在这边可以看到有政府，同时呢最上面有游说的团体，另外呢可能可以有的是银行，就是出钱给你提供资本的人。
This is just to give you a visual guide. It's not saying this is what you should do, but it might be something that helps you think about it or explain when you're talking to your group.
那这个呢，只是给大家有一个具象化、更具体的看一下这几个关系可能长什么样子，并不是说各位一定要照着这个模式走，而是至少让大家跟其他人讨论的时候可以有一个比较具体的东西。
Kia ora, thank you, 谢谢，
谢谢，
马上回来。
I'm not here to sell geothermal to you.
Sorry.
在这里想要先跟各位澄清，各位不要误会，我不是来这里卖地热。
12 years ago, we opposed a 250 megawatt geothermal application.
12年前，我们呢就反对了250 megawatt 这个地热的应用。
It cost us over $1 million.
它让我们因此呢，花费了大概浪费了大概100万台币。
In New Zealand, we have what they call the Environment Court, and if you oppose it, you go to the Environment Court.
因为那时候，当我们损失了100万台币，因为在纽西兰呢，我们基本上有个叫做环境法院，所以如果你反对的话，你就要上台环境法院。
We lost.
我们输了。
But our story got recorded, and our rights through the ones we had got more deeper entrenched, and that was around that company having to report to us.Around the impact on the environment, how they were protecting the resource, and then our rights to the downstream opportunities.
那但是呢，我们的故事被记录下来了呢。接着呢，我们的权利也因此有所深化，有所发展。所以在那之后呢，那边的公司呢，这边在那边开发的公司呢，就必须要回头来告诉我们说，第一个，它对环境造成什么样的影响，同时也告诉我们，我们在下游是有权利的。
So when I was born.The first geothermal power plant was already operating in our tribal area.
所以我在出生的时候呢，我们自己部落那边第一个电厂，地热电厂早就已经在运转中了。
So it was normalized.
对我来说就已经是正常化了，已经是很正常的一件事。
Like the internet and the cell phone is to our children.
其实就像是手机对我们的小孩子来说一样，非常的自然，非常的正常。
So to finish, we have to emphasize.Our priority is protection of the resource for the future generations.
所以最后想要做结的是，我们要强调的是，我们的优先顺序是要保护资源，保障下一代。
And that's a very fine balance between being stuck to not do anything, and then making sure that you're informed to make the right choice to move forward for your future opportunities that sit there.
那这其实是一个非常难维持的一个平衡。我们在什么都不做，跟就是要确保说我们真的有知情的知道这些资讯以后，做出正确的决定，为了下一个世代来做。
He's not here to sell you how good geothermal is, but I am.
他没有来卖说地热，但是我是来卖地热的。
I joke because I represent geothermal companies that come to Taiwan.
没有开玩笑的，但是确实，因为他们是贸易办事处，所以有代表在来到台湾的纽西兰的地热公司。
But these issues are global issues. You know, climate change, carbon emission, global warming, all of those types of things. What's going to be good for the world and for our next generations? So you need to be having these conversations, regardless of what you do.
所以，但是这一些问题跟这些趋势其实是全球性的，气候变迁。碳排、全球暖化，我们对下一个世代要做一些什么？那其实这一些是不管你要做些什么事情，你都还是必须要有这样的对话的。谢谢。
没有关系，我们有10分钟的时间，来那个把上先好，把上好，好，把上好，名字，那把上，对对，就他。
是的。哎，感谢，我用中文哈，那也请翻译帮忙。刚刚有听到一个词啊 ，Maori land， 好，那不晓得你们知不知道，这个跟台湾的原住民的土地，你现在在讲 Maori land 啊，那这个 Maori land， 是不是有像台湾原住民一样有？个人的，我们台湾原住民很多人非常骄傲，我们有原住土地，我们自己取得这个所有权状。所以我想回到上一个 slide， 好，上一个 slide， 麻烦一下，不好意思啊。我看到这个图哈，不是，就刚刚那个，他在讲那个，那个 entity。啊，呀呀呀 ，That's right， 好，这个， 原住民的 tribal entity， 好，是他们整个运作。我一这样一看过去，整个运作的一个重点在这里，那就觉得说，纽西兰的白人怎么这么笨，跟台湾的公司不一样啊？刚刚我们前面很多官员一直在讲，我们台湾地热的发展哦，重点在哪里？怎么样让这个地热公司它探勘的成本可以承受掉，然后我们政府怎么样帮助它能够做得下去？那我们的原住民根本就，我这样讲哈不对，也请在座的朋友们也指正我哈，根本就没有这个东西，什么 indigenous tribal entity。我们所说的啊，我们部落我们要来经营，我们讲的跟我现在听起来他的在讲的那个 entity， 还有就是说以部落为基础的那个 cooperation， 我们讲的不一样。我们原住民的公司是什么？是我们原住民哦，你有你保留地，你有地，你有地啊，我们合起来，我们开一个公司啊，来跟平地人竞争。我们讲的是这个，我的感觉是说，那为什么他们的这个白人哦，请教一下，怎么那么笨呢？怎么没有来跟原住民收购？我们的那个地热哈，如果说是长在保留地上面，啊，他一定会去查那个是谁拥有的啊。我们的公司一定是这样，然后赶快去跟他谈条件，啊，不用经过部落谘商同意，我取得土地。我们台湾的所有的企业、矿产啊，什么都是这样。哦，啊，那个原住民他如果说，我不晓得，大部分一定程度的报酬，他可能就会跟平地人合作了。哦，所以说，为什么他们白人没有像我们台湾这样，就不会去个别去收购那 private 的那个 property， 那个叫做个人的那个土地？啊，我就是问这一点。那也请我们在场的原住民能够指正我一下，谢谢。
我们先把问题先收集完，我们再一次的请 Tina 这边帮我们回应。那这位，
我想要提问的比较会是，比如说原住民的部落跟其他三种类别群体的关系。第一种是可能像刚刚 Tina 提到的，是可能部落跟部落之间过去也曾经会有冲突。但是今天如果遇到比如说有开发商要进来，或者是有政府要来使用这些土地的时候，彼此之间怎么样开始合作。然后第二种群体是我相信应该也会跟台湾有类似的地方，是可能部落也会跟环境的 NGO 之间可能也会互相的合作。对，那不晓得可不可以分享一些纽西兰的经验。那第三个群体就比较会是跟政府之间，因为其实看起来纽西兰现在各个法人或政治实体上是很完整的，那应该是经历了很多的抗争或者是争取。对，那跟政府在对话的时候大概需要去善用什么来去争取，比如说台湾光是要争取一个实质的自治权就非常的困难这样子，所以就会好奇哦。再来还有跟政府也有点关系的是，现在有毛利党，但是应该2000年以前没有毛利党，所以原住民跟比如说绿党本身就是跟原住民族也是价值体系很接近的。对，那还有什么样的政党是不是在国会里面也会为原住民族去争取权益或者去推进这样子？谢谢。
刚才这位讲师站在前面讲了一句话，站在决策的前面。台湾原住民族，请问在场的台湾的原住民族，有没有站在决策前面的这个勇气跟力道？这样子，我要讲这句话， 才有形成他刚才讲的这个鱼，这个过程当中的一个流程。重点是，台湾原住民族在120年前被日本人统治，后来的人来的中华民国，到现在，我们现在处在这个土地上的原住民，你们到底在想什么？然后跟敌人，这个中华民国这个不是国家的国家，我们在跟他谈什么？所以刚才这位小姐讲，站在决策的前面，其实我的理解，当下的原住民，你要站在你的族群的永续的存在的历史，然后跟中华民国政权谈判，这样你才有站在决策的前面的勇气。以上。
想问那个天涯处长，因为刚刚有提到像族人在参与地热开发的过程中是需要资本的，那资本可能来自于政府，也可能来自于那些有钱的人。想要问的是，通常会吸引这些有钱人来投资的原因是哪些？那比方说像土地信托的方式，在纽西兰也是一个毛利人蛮常进行土地信托、土地管理的一个方式。那吸引这些资本家来投资的原因是不是跟土地信托的方式有关？那如果是的话，能不能分享一下这当中的利益分配的方式？谢谢。
Sorry, one more.
忘了，给你对吗？要
忘掉了。毛利的那个发电厂，地热的发电厂，有没有注入那个水抽出来之后，有没有再注入废水进去？那如果有注入废水的话，他们怎么确保他们的后代子孙可以永远的享用一个很好的环境权？
Wow, there are some good questions and important questions, and some of them are for you to your own people, which is important. I'll start with the last one. Geothermal power plants in New Zealand re-injecting of wastewater. How can you ensure that the re-injection is of good quality?
好，
I'm going to hand that to Tim.
好，很多很不错的问题呢，有些很重要的问题，另外有一些重要的问题是问给部落的人本身的，但是这些都是非常重要的问题。那我们先从最后一个问题开始回答：纽西兰在使用地热资源的时候，有没有注入、回注这个废水的这件事情？那如果有回注的话，要怎么样去确保说它不会影响到接下来的世代？我们把这个时间交给 Tim。
Don't trust the scientists that are employed by the geothermal company.
不要相信科学家，他们是地热公司雇用的。
You have to make sure you've got scientists on your side that are going to keep them honest.
你要确保是你自己这边有站在你这边的你自己的科学家，然后他们能够让这些人是老实面对的。
好。I think that's a very important statement, regardless of what phase you're in, making sure you have representatives for your group as part of the inside the circle of knowledge.
那我觉得不管我们目前是在哪一个阶段，这个都是非常重要的一句话，非常重要的一个宣言，就是你必须要确保是在知识的整个回圈里面是有人在代表你们族人的。
I'll go to the question now, the second, I think, question, which was, you know, how do you bring tribal groups to work together collectively when you might have your own choices and desires?
那我就先回答第二个问题，就是部落之间要怎么样彼此之间合作，因为部落之间可能会有不同的想法，不同的意见。
We have this challenge too.There's always one uncle or one auntie or one cousin who's doing the deal.
我们也有这样的挑战，可能每次就是那个阿姨、那个叔叔、那个表弟在负责这一次的这个谈判。
So that comes back to that original question, Dalaba, around making sure you've got a very good communication structure in place that these are the formal meetings that our people are talking about.
那所以这回到是原本一开始讨论的问题，你要确保的是你们有非常好的一个沟通的架构跟结构，确保说我们在讲到这些东西的时候，我们会在这些正式的会议里面谈到。
And so when tribal group number one are clear on what's important for them, they go and be tribal with their other cousins and tell them about that and hear what's important to your other group.
那所以呢，当部落一，譬如说他们已经知道说非常清楚有共识，知道自己要什么的时候，他们就去其他的部落去跟部落讲说对他们来说重要的是什么。
And you work out what are the common things that are important to you both.
然后你们部落之间就去想是对你们来说你们共通很重要的东西是什么。
Now, Tim, when I first met him, he looked a lot younger than he does.
Tim, 我一开始认识他的时候，他比现在看起来年轻很多。
Because it's hard. It takes time.
因为很难，而且很耗时。
And, you know, the most important stakeholders are your people. And like we said at the beginning, that is some of the trickiest. So education,You know, the information, communicate, take time to listen, and then we have a decision-making process which is autocratic.
那再来呢是就是因为部落其实照理说最重要的这些利害关系，这一切其实就最终是这些部落的族人。那其实当然这也是一开始提到的是最棘手、最难的，所以你要确保是整个资讯的一些传播啊，整个教育啊，还有沟通啊，然后还要花时间去倾听，还有整个决策的过程是真的是民主的，真的是自觉的。
So we will listen to everyone's views. We also have direction.And then we will make decisions based on that.
那我们呢就会去听大家的想法，我们会有一些仪式，然后最后呢根据这些东西我们做决定。
We have the same. I know the people are behind me. I can feel their knives in my back.
我们其实也有一样，是我知道我后面有人，我还可以我感觉到他的鼻息。
And I suppose that's another point.You do it because you love your people, not to make them like you.
那其实另外也我们之所以这么做的原因，就是因为你这样做的话，别人就不需要这么做了。你是为了人这么做，不是要让他们喜欢你来才这么做。
There's no magic pill for that. There's no magic solution, but you at least start.
所以没有万灵丹，但是至少就是要做到为了他们做，但是不是为了人家喜欢你而做。
We got forced into tribal structures.
我们是也被迫进入到这一个 tribal 的这个部落的这个结构。
We don't really care about what legal, what legislation sits behind the type of structure. As long as we preserve the only way you can belong is because you descend from the common ancestor.
那我们不在乎的是这个背后的立法的整个结构，我们知道的是我们之所以存在，我们之所以有归属感，是因为我们来自于同一个祖先。
So you can only belong if it's passed down from your grandparents and your parents, or you can prove your genealogy tie to the principal ancestor.
所以你之所以能够有归属，是因为这个人是你爷爷奶奶。传下来给你的，或者是你能够证明说，在整个族谱谱系里面呢，是有这样一个连接的。
The next question was, how do you leverage your rights, around making sure you get to participate when you're talking to government? So our situation is, we do have a treaty, so we have that ultimate founding document to point to.But you'll need to think about what legislation is in play that represents the Indigenous rights and work out whether those need changing. You know, there might be a whole lot of steps prior to making that happen.
那这样讲说的是在政府上面里面是有哪些人可以帮他们说话。那讲到的是，其实在政府来说话最重要的是他们跟政府有签这个协约。根据这个协约呢，其实就一切最终至少能够指挥去说我们要去根据这个协约。所以要确保的是，可能你在立法上面看一看说哪一些是可以代表原住民权利的，有可能是这样的一个立法也不够，所以可能需要一些改变，这一切可能需要一步一步的来。
Yeah, get your people who are working inside the government to come and talk to you, and talk to you, and talk with you, listen to you, and then take that back.
所以让你们的族人到政府里面内部去跟工作，让他们去跟你们谈，一直谈，一直谈，谈到坐下来一起谈。谈完了以后呢，听你们的讲话，听你们的意见，听你们的想法，把你们的意见跟想法带回去。
And do it again, and do it again, and do it again.
然后再继续做，再做一次，再做一次，再继续做。
I work for my government, but I am a Māori woman first, and so you need to remind some of your family members maybe.
所以虽然我可能在政府上有一些职位，但重点的是我是毛利人优先，所以呢，有可能你要提醒你们的主人，你要想到这件事情。
There's the next question around. We've got a oops.
We're just on a different stage of our renaissance and rebuilding our cultural identity, self-pride, our language, our culture.
那我们目前呢，其实是属于复兴的不同阶段，不管是我们自己文化上、身份认同上、语言上，还有我们的自然习惯惯习上面，我们可能都在不同的复兴阶段。
Our activist years were in the 1960s and the 1970s.
我们开始采取行动，然后开始去积极的捍卫，其实是从1960年、1970年代就开始。
And it was through that activism of my parents, I'm the last of that generation. We were a lot more aggressive than our kids because they didn't feel the loss and the pain as much as my parents and my grandparents. And it was through that activism that we forced the government.To acknowledge our rights. That didn't happen until the late 80s, early 90s of the establishment of what's called now the Waitangi Tribunal. And only then were our treaty rights now acknowledged. Up until then, it was just one way, stuff was just taken away from us.
那从1960年代开始的这个行动主义，我们祖父母被一直以来的努力，到了我们现在跟我们的下一代，才可以没有感受到这么多当初他们感受到的痛苦跟他们失去的这个失落，所以这些东西慢慢的才把权力闹回来，一直到1980年代晚期、1990年代初期才把这些权力慢慢的调回来，开始有了这个瓦塔尼这个法院法庭，不然一开始的时候，就算之前曾经1840年签订的这个条约协约，其实没有人要管。
We talk about education. We were very intentional when our Renaissance was happening, and I'm sure that's also happening here too, in the best way.
那讲到教育的话呢，其实我们当初在复兴的这整个过程中的话，这个教育是非常有意识的。那我相信在这边应该也是有发生这样的事情，而且是最好的方式在发生。
We call ourselves treaty babies.
我们叫自己条约宝宝。
Because the first wave ran off to be lawyers.
因为第一代的去当律师了。
Second wave went off to be accountants, and then followed by investment.
然后第二波呢，大家去会计师。
Because we needed to know how to manage things.And then in between that, there was all the social and the health and the wellness sector.
那再来，因为你知道要怎么样管理这些东西，那当然这中间又有一些，比如说社福啊，然后相关的健康啊等等这一些产业。
So it's still very, very recent for us too, and it's working out what's going to be important, where you put your energy, because you can't do all of it. So how might you consider what you do and be effective?
所以这其实对我们来说都是非常近期的事情，那这当然也很重要。可是重要的也是想说，对你们来说，你们的优先顺序什么？因为你不可能所有一次就直接到位做到，所以你要先想一下，对你们来说重要的东西是什么。
one of the other questions was around, well, how do you get other people to be champions for you?
那另外有个问题呢，是说你要怎么样让大家也为你说话？
These are people that know doing what's right is good for everybody.
他们这些人呢是知道说做对的事对所有人都好。
You have to be able to articulate what's important for you.
但你也必须要非常具体清楚的说出来说对你来说重要的是什么。
Now you've got to go through the emotional journey to then get to the sound and reasonable discussion space.
那当然，你可能会先经历过一段情绪的转折，最终呢，你知道说要怎么样用理性的声音传达这一些想法。
So that's one of those answers.
大概回答这里。
Māori Party. So our New Zealand only has 5 million people. 很少。
纽西兰只有500万人，所以很少。
And our politics is very small also.
所以我们的政治人物也不多。
It was raised that we have a Māori party, which is one of the political parties.
那刚刚讲到说我们有毛利党，就是其中一个政党。
Which is great, and so and it's right. They rightly align themselves with the Green Party and those more social and environmental and long-term outcomes.
那没有错，确实是如此。这当然很棒。那当然跟绿党比起来，他们当然在这些社会啊，跟这些环境的这一些就是结果啊，跟这些政策上面相对来说是比较一致的。
But in New Zealand, we have a voting system where you can choose similar to here to be on the mainstream roll or the Māori electoral roll.
但是呢，在纽西兰，我们的投票系统是有些呢是选的是主流社会的这些代表，有些呢是毛利的代表。
And you can switch between the two depending on which election round you want to participate in.
然后你可以根据你自己想要参与的选举呢，你自己去选择你要选的投票的人到底是谁。
And because we have a Māori roll, we have 7 Māori electorates that people get to vote on, so they have 7 seats regardless.
对，因为呢，我们就是有这个毛利人在那边占了一定比例，所以我们基本上有投票的这个毛利人呢，可以当选的这个席次呢是7个席次。
But the last government, we just had our elections back in October, and we've got a new government, which is not so great at the moment. But the previous government, the ruling party, the lead party, the government.They had many Māori people in multiple seats, mainstream and Māori well.
那上一个十月呢，我们是要选举呢，其实不太好。前一个执政党基本上他们有获得的是，就是不管是主流社会的这个席次，也获得是毛利的席次。
But because our Māori party is always in opposition, they're always fighting the good fight, and they can be quite activism in their approach.
但是呢，因为我们自己本身有这个机构会发生，他们永远的就是要打场好仗，所以就算没有这样的一个席次代表，其实还是可以做很好的倡议。
Yeah, politics is hard, for those representing us.
那对于代表我们来说，当然政治是不容易的。
But they put their hand up, so they should do it.
但是他们自己要选择自己自愿的，所以他们得做。
I think we've done most of the questions. Yaba?
Yes.
那大多数的问题应该都回答完了，对吧？嗯。
And how do you be courageous, Uncle? It's you know, keep challenging yourselves. Call on your cousins to help get in behind you.
那要怎么样真的是勇敢呢？其实真的是持续挑战自己，然后叫你的部族兄弟姐妹全部一起来帮助你，站在你后面支持你。
谢谢Thank you。他们未来几天都会跟我们一起哦，包含说明天的工作坊，然后后天的这个参访。所以说，如果还有一些问题想请教，也当然可以再交流。不过不要把问题藏在心里面哦，旁边有那个议题墙哦，我们赶快把问题提出来，我们明天可以讨论的更丰富。